Good evening from Gwangju, Korea, and the Universiade Stadium, site of the opening ceremony for the 2015 Summer Universiade. My name is Doug McLean, and I'm pleased to be here tonight to bring you all the action from the opening ceremony, all the pageantry that you will see over the course of this evening. So many people involved in putting on an event like this, and you can see the crowd already getting into things here just before we get going. A beautiful day here in Gwangju, temperature right around 26 degrees Celsius, a little bit overcast for the ceremony tonight, but no rain in the forecast, so that's perfect. The organizers will be able to put on a show without having to worry about the elements. Competition has already begun in certain sports, and we'll touch on that as much as we can over the course of the evening. But of course, tonight it is about the athletes. It's about introducing them, bringing them into the stadium as we kick off the 28th Summer Universiade here in South Korea. Crowd just getting warmed up here a little bit. There you see the beautiful Universiade Stadium as people continue to file in and find their seats. Tonight's ceremony will focus a lot around light. Of course, as we head into the evening, light will become a very major factor in what is presented here this evening. You get a good look at some of the spectators as we get closer to the official beginning of these opening ceremonies. ...170 countries represented here at Universiade. And they will come out midway through the ceremony, as is traditional. Now the crowd fully into things. The executive director of this opening ceremony is Park Myung-sung, and the chief and artistic director is Kim Tae-wook. As we mentioned, light a major factor. Light up tomorrow, one of the themes, along with You Are Shining, another theme of this evening's presentation. And there you see the ever-present U, common in all of the logos in the history of the World University Games. And of course, present very much with that scrolling banner making up the U here at the Universiade Stadium. Crowd and being brought very much into this ceremony. The Korean flags there in the hands of many of the spectators here this evening.
Turn left. Turn left.
fans now playing a major participatory role here.
So, 이제부터 아까 했던 파도팽이를 한번 해보도록 하겠습니다. 저기부터 파도팽이.
We will walk through over the course of the evening a few different cultural presentations, three to be exact. Of course, we will have the traditional entrance of the Universiad flag, the Korean flag and anthem, the lighting of the cauldron later in the evening, and then, as I already mentioned, of course, the parade of athletes make their way into the stadium. So midway through the evening, for the next couple seconds, we'll let the sights and sounds, as you see them here, carry things along. A beautiful aerial shot here of the Universiad Stadium. Nice day here in Gwangju. Not overly hot. This is the hottest month of the year in Gwangju, also the one that has the most rain.
The
rain has stayed away here today.
A
little bit of wind. You can see the flags there just under the canopy of each side of the stadium blowing a little bit.
정말 대단한 게 지금부터 이제 곧 있으면 생방송이 120여 국에 송출이 됩니다. 이 현장을 여러분들과 함께 라이브로 함께하고 있다는 자체가 너무나도 대단하고 영광스럽다고 생각드려요. 이 순간
And what the idea that youth is the beginning of light into the future, and with passion and the power of creation, youth has created the history of mankind. Now they will light up and be the leaders of tomorrow. And at the opening and closing ceremonies, the youth will sublimate the power and hope into light, discover the light within themselves, and finally draw their glorious future. These are some of the words from Park Myung-sung, the executive director.
여러분 환영합니다. 이제 잠시 후 본격적인 개회식 순서가 진행됩니다. 관람객 여러분들께서는 자리를 떠나지 마시고 오늘 축제의 순간을 마음껏 즐겨주시기 바랍니다. 국제 방송 신호 제작을 위해 잠시 사일런스 타임을 갖도록 하겠습니다. 국제 방송 신호를 위해 잠시만 기다려 주시기 바랍니다.
South Korea previously hosted the World University Games, or last hosted it in 2003.
I'm Ban Ki-moon, Secretary General of the United Nations. I send my best wishes to all of you gathered in Gwangju for the 28th Summer Universiad Games. I commend the organizing committee for its commitment. Congratulations to the thousands of students who have come from around the world to celebrate education, culture, and sports. The United Nations deeply values sports as a catalyst for progress. Athletic competitions promote friendship, understanding, respect, and fair play. Your summer Universiad can help promote a more sustainable, just, and peaceful future. I wish you great success in the competition, and I urge you to stand together as global citizens. When it comes to our planet, we are all on the same team. Let us win by leaving a better world for generations to come. Thank you. 감사합니다.
We have the words of head of the United Nations, Ban Ki-moon. This piece you're seeing now is entitled The Sound That Awakens Youth. Part of the welcoming ceremony to kick things off for tonight's opening. By Kindyoksu Seminyori. Again, you see that you that will form a major part of tonight's festivities. Acting as a part of the stage. Energetic way to get these opening ceremonies at these 28th World University Games underway. Various youth performers, they make their way down the stairs and to field level.
Haribo,
This will lead us into the second chapter of this welcoming ceremony, called Light the Song of Youth. The theme for this evening being, You Are Shining. As represented in this way, just as how a ray of light disturbed the darkness to announce the beginning of all life, youth was born with mankind and has lightened the history until now. With the eternal passion and challenge, they have ceaselessly learned, communicated, and created glorious civilizations. Youth will inquire the future once again today in front of this splendid light. Why is the world still dark when we have that much light? The answer is with us, the youth of this era. Now we wish to embody life and love and light the ways into a new future. We will take hands with youth from all around the world to create a bright future with the energy and life of youth. You are shining. Youth is the light of the future. This is certainly being demonstrated with all the young performers down on the stage on the main field of play. Of the scale and scope of these opening ceremonies. Everything from rings to what appear to be almost plates or cooking tools of some variety. So definitely a range of percussion going on the stage right now. This is some examples. Water jugs, bowls.
전 춤이라고 생각해요.
비행기라고 생각해요.
달콤한 인생이라고 생각합니다.
자유로움.
지치지 않는 것?
불타는 마음이라고 생각합니다.
나의 삶을 찾는 과정?
활기참인 것 같아요.
저는 즐거움이라고 생각하는데요.
경쟁력이라고 생각이 됩니다.
한정된 즐거움이라고 생각해요.
한 번 죽었다고 끝나지 않는 게임이에요.
뭐든지 할 수 있다.
인생의 황금기 아닐까요?
굴러가는 바퀴와도 같죠?
에너지.
그 에너지가 제가 생각하기에는 젊음인 것 같아요.
젊음이란 생명이다.
젊음은 무한한 가능성이다.
Some of the youth of Korea. Some keywords and messages that relate and tie back to Universiad. Yeah. Second part of the welcoming ceremony, light the song of youth. Abracadabra.
원우씨.
제일 먼저 떠오르는 거는 민주도시.
민주화의 도시.
민주화의 도시죠.
문화도시를 나타내는
문화적인 느낌?
문화의 고장?
문화의 예술의 본고장이 아닐까.
문화도시.
빛고을?
빛고을이요.
빛의 도시가 떠올라요.
빛의 도시인 것 같아요.
광천터미널.
맛있는 남도 음식.
활기가 넘치는 것 같아요.
사람과 사람 사이의 정.
전라도 사람들만의 의리가 아닐까요?
따뜻함.
뭐 시민의식이 좀 더 많은 것 같아요.
저희 광주 시민들만의 그런 뜨거운 마음이라고 할까요?
젊은 사람들이 깨어있다고 해야 하나요?
네, 실천적인 정신이 제일 더.
전라도의 중심이 아닐까요?
네, the youth of Gwangju speak about their city. Certainly what they hope this city will continue to become through the fact that they are hosting these World University Games in 2015. Gwangju, a city of about 1.5 million people in the southwestern portion of South Korea, the sixth largest city in the country. It's about a 3.5 hour drive south of Seoul. Of course, this country no stranger to hosting major events. Seoul hosting the 1988 Summer Olympics. And they will host the 2018 Winter Olympics in Pyeongchang. We did mention before as well that Daegu hosted the 2003
지금 2015 광주 하계 유니버시아드 대회 개회식장에 개최국 대한민국 박근혜 대통령께서 입장하고 계십니다. 큰 박수로 환영해 주시기 바랍니다.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the President of the Republic of Korea, Park Geun-hye.
Park Geun-hye, the President of the Republic of Korea. There you see her. To her right is Claude-Louis Gallien, the President of FISU.
걸치고 대한민국의 국기가 입장하겠습니다.
Korean military fly by over top of the stadium.
일어나 주시기 바랍니다.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the national flag of the Republic of Korea. Please rise from your seats.
1992년 바르셀로나 올림픽 마라톤 종목 금메달리스트인 국민체육진흥공단 황영조 마라톤 감독과 미래의 한국 체육을 빛낼 유망주들이 함께 입장하고 있습니다.
Hwang Young-jo, the marathon gold medalist in the 1992 Barcelona Olympics and the coach of Korea Sports Promotion Foundation, is joined by the rising sports stars of Korea.
먼저 근대 3종 경기 종목의 윤상민 군.
First,
윤상민, triathlon.
Presented as they will bring
육상 종목의 꿈나무인 한승환 군입니다.
한승환, athletics.
Flag of the Republic of Korea.
수영 종목의 남상아 양.
남상아, swimming.
양궁 종목의 박연경 양.
박연경, archery.
에어로빅 종목의 김혁 군.
김혁, aerobics.
정구 종목의 양일현 군.
양일현, soft tennis.
배구 종목의 김가연 양.
김가연, volleyball.
육상 종목의 황지향 양입니다.
황지향, athletics.
Flag has been passed on. Members of the Korean military will now officially raise it. Here inside Universiad Stadium.
Yes, sir. 개최국가 연주와 함께 개최 국기를 개양하겠습니다.
Next, we will hoist the national flag of the Republic of Korea with the national anthem.
모두 국기 개양대를 향해 주시기 바랍니다.
Please face the flag.
네. Of the anthem of the Republic of Korea performed there by Kim Jae-hyung and Park Hye-jin.
이제 젊음의 탄생을 주제로 한 첫 번째 문화 공연이 시작되겠습니다.
We will now begin the first cultural performance titled Light, the Birth of Youth.
As you heard there from our Masters of Ceremonies, Light, The Birth of Youth.
Thank you.
Last thought there. Light the birth of youth, the theme of his first cultural performance. Just as energy and light is created upon the collision of yin and yang, the youth shines its light when various knowledge and ideas fiercely collide and form harmony. This first chapter is called The Fetal Movement. Face of the void, the force of yin and yang starts to move. Yang, the fetal dancer you see raised above the stage. Dancer also rising above the stage. Chapter called Encounter and Harmony. The dynamic movements that symbolize the force of yin and yang meet one another and merge to give birth to the light, youth. Chapters here of Light, the Birth of Youth. There's the collision. To move us into the third chapter. This third chapter is called Youth Spreads Its Wings. Now youth will spread their wings of beautiful light and start their flight toward the world in Guangzhou. Fireworks atop the stadium.
이제 2015 광주 하계 유니버시아드 대회 참가국 선수단이 입장하겠습니다.
The first cultural performance.
새로운 도전을 앞둔 143개국의 선수단이 영문 알파벳 순으로 입장하겠습니다.
We will now welcome the delegations
from 143 countries. They will enter in alphabetical order. Please welcome them with a big round of applause.
143 countries making up the final total of entrants of country participants, I should say, here for Universiade in Gwangju.
Afghanistan.
It'll be Afghanistan that leads the way. Of course, if you're used to watching the Olympic Games, it is traditionally Greece that enters first, but that is, of course, specific
Algeria.
To the Olympic Games and the fact that they were birthed in ancient Greece. No such tradition here, although the first ever
Angola.
World
Angola.
University Games took place in Turin, Italy, back in 1959, so I suppose you could make an argument that that is the birthplace
Anguilla
of Universia.
Anguilla.
Anguilla now making its way out.
Argentina.
Let's see one of the good-sized delegation here from the Argentinians as they make their way out. Typical enthusiasm from the South Americans, encouraging the crowd to really get into things. They've already been into things here so far this evening. Armenia make its way down Armenia. Onto the field.
Armenia.
Armenia.
You can see, of course, the flags being brought in. But then equally within the crowd, you'll see the name of the country flashing across the seats. Another way to demonstrate countries that are participating. And now Aruba.
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 Aruba. Hoju.
Pretty common thing there, as you see
Australia.
Armenian or the Aruba, the flag bearer for Aruba, capturing some images with his camera. And now Australia. Larger delegations you will see here. A traditional sport power in many disciplines. Swimming being one that they have been extremely successful at. But despite its strength in sport, Australia has never hosted the World University Games. And Austria now entering the stadium. As I said earlier, 143 countries participating, approximately 10,000 athletes.
Azerbaijan.
Azerbaijan.
We have 272 events in 21 sports. As Azerbaijan makes its way out.
Bangladesh.
Followed right behind by Bangladesh.
Barbados.
And there you see the flag of Barbados. Small island country in the Caribbean.
Belarus.
Belarus.
And now Belarus.
Belgium.
Belgium.
Belgium. Makes its way out. Belgium, one of the two homes of FISU. FISU, of course, being the International University Sports Federation. And Brussels has been its home for many years.
Benin.
They now also have a significant presence in Lausanne, Switzerland. Of course, Lausanne, famous for being the headquarters of many major international sports organizations, including the International Olympic Committee. And there is Bhutan.
Bosnia, Herzegovina.
Distinctive
Bosnia and Herzegovina.
Flag with the dragon blazed across it. Now Bosnia and Herzegovina.
Botswana.
Botswana.
Followed right behind by Botswana.
Brazil.
Brazil.
And Brazil. Brazil has hosted one Summer University Games back in 1963 in Porto Alegre. And they were scheduled to host in 2019. But there are some financial challenges with Brasilia, which was to be the host city. So the actual host of and location of those 2019 Summer University Games is still to be determined. Brazil, of course, getting ready to host the 2016 Summer Olympics in Rio de Janeiro, the first time that the Olympics will be brought to the continent of South America. Of course, they also hosted the World Cup of Football 1 year ago, won by Germany. There you see Burkina Faso.
Burundi.
Burundi.
Followed right behind by another African country, Burundi.
Cambodia.
Cambodia.
Cambodge.
There you see Cambodia.
Cameroon.
Looking very businesslike in their suits.
Cameroon.
Now Cameroon.
Canada.
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 There you see the Canadians. The ever-present Maple Leaf, a country just celebrating Canada Day 2 days ago on July 1st, its 148th birthday. Canada has hosted one World University Games in Edmonton back in 1983. And interestingly enough, Edmonton was one of three bidding cities for these 2015 games that were ultimately won by Guangzhou. Large Canadian delegation making its way out onto the field. World University Games have only been hosted, the summer version, only hosted in North America twice. Once in Edmonton, as mentioned, back in 1983. And then in Buffalo, in the United States, in 1993. These cell phones everywhere, almost as many cell phones as you see flags with the participants. Canada, the largest delegation so far here tonight to make its way into the stadium.
Chad!
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 And Chad, right in behind Canada. On camera being a little bit overtaken
Chile.
By the slightly jubilant Canadians.
Chile.
And now Chile. Of course, it's a great thrill for these athletes getting the opportunity to march behind their country's flag. Some of them doing it for the first time and maybe the only time. Some of them doing it for the second or greater number of times. Of course, some of these athletes competing at various other major international events. Either their own specific sport world championships, domestic games, or regional games such as the Commonwealth Games or the Asian Games or, of course, of the Olympics.
People's Republic of China.
République Populaire
now, the People's
de
Republic
Chine.
Of China. Also one of the largest delegations that you will see here in Guangzhou. China has hosted two Summer University Games. First back in 2001 in Beijing, which opened the door for Beijing to host the 2008 Summer Olympics with their experience there. And then in Shenzhen, a mere 4 years ago, as that city of 12 million people hosted Summer Universiade. China has also hosted one Winter Universiade that took place back in 2009 in Harbin. Beijing looking to become the first ever city to host both a Summer and Winter Olympics, as they are bidding for the 2022 Winter Olympics, and they are bidding actually against Almaty, Kazakhstan. And Almaty is the next host of the Winter World University Games to take place in early 2017. Very large Chinese delegation making its way out onto the field. Colombia follows up China. Colombia made a bit of a splash on the world sports stage recently as they were competing in the Women's World Cup of Football in Canada. Colombia stayed tight to the United States of America.
Camara.
Their round of 16 game, although the Americans did ultimately win. Actually, the Americans will play in the final of that tournament in Vancouver, Canada, on this upcoming Sunday.
Costa Rica. Côte d'Ivoire.
Now Côte d'Ivoire, or the Ivory Coast, French-speaking nation in Africa.
Croatia.
And there is Croatia.
Cuba.
And there is Cuba, right in behind the Croatians.
Curaçao.
There is Curaçao.
Kipros.
The Caribbean
Cyprus.
Nation.
Cyprus
right in behind them.
Czech Republic.
République Czech.
Now the Czech Republic. Making its way out. Have never hosted a summer Universiad, but have twice hosted the Winter Games in 1978 in Splendorov, Mil, and then in 1987 in Tursky Pleso. Now that is on the Slovakian side, so when the country split, that is now part of Slovakia. And actually, Strbski Pleso was one of the two hosts of the most recent Winter Universiad, as they hosted part of the sports program, while the remainder was held in Granada, Spain.
Denmark.
And now the Danes will enter Universiad Stadium. As you can see, the sun has more or less set here in Gwangju.
Nicaragua.
Dominican Republic.
République Dominicaine.
Now the Dominican Republic. You get just in behind there that sunset. Here in Guangzhou as we kick off these 28th Summer University Ecuador. Games.
Ecuador.
Ecuador.
Now Ecuador.
El Salvador.
El Salvador.
Followed by another El South Salvador. American country in El Salvador.
As
mentioned,
Equatorial
Brazil
Guinea.
In South America Guinea has hosted
Equatorial.
The Summer Universiade.
Estonia.
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 Now Estonia.
Ethiopia.
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 Followed up by Ethiopia. Of course, one of the strongest
Finland.
Distance running
Finland.
Countries in the world.
Finland.
And now Finland enters the stadium here. Never a host of a Summer Universiade, but did host the 1970 Winter Games in Rovaniemi.
France.
Helsinki did host the 1952
France.
Summer Olympics.
France.
And now France. Always a strong sporting power in the world. And host of many major events. Although again, interestingly enough, they have never hosted a Summer Universiade. They did host a Winter Universiade in Chamonix. Chamonix also the site of the first ever Winter Olympics in 1924. And there is Claude-Louis Gallien and his wife. Both French citizens as they welcome their team into the stadium. So it's Chamonix, the first ever host of the Winter Universiade and as well the Winter Olympics. Things are certainly different in terms of how these ceremonies are done. Back in 1924, for those first ever Winter Olympics held in Chamonix, the athletes actually paraded through town with their equipment. So you would see sleds and skis and skates making their way through the town.
Gabon!
So you don't see that here. We're not seeing paddles or basketballs or javelins or anything making their way. It's just the athletes. So a significant change in terms
Democratic
of how these ceremonies
Republic of the Congo.
Take place.
Congo.
Now
Gambia.
The Democratic Republic of the
Gambia.
Congo.
Gambia.
Followed by Gambia.
Georgia.
And they'll be followed
Georgia.
By Georgia.
Georgia.
Tokyo.
Germany.
Alemania.
So a couple smaller delegations, and now Germany. Germany, the host of the Summer Universiade back in 1989 in Duisburg, when it was still West Germany. Right there, you see the German athletes taking a picture with the mascot.
Ghana.
And the official mascot for the Summer Universiade, as you see Ghana make its way out, the name is Naribi. And Naribi is a combination of the Korean words Nuri for world and B for fly. As Haiti makes its way out, followed by Honduras.
Honduras.
And Naribi is described as the messenger of light, symbol of Gwangju's Universiade vision, and a bridge of communication of the world's youth, which spreads hope of creation to deliver light to the world. And Hong Kong, China makes its way out. Very bright uniforms they have.
Hungary!
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 And now the Hungarians. Budapest hosted the 1965 World University Games. And has historically made a couple bids for the Olympics. And as I understand it, looking at another one. They've also, to my understanding, contemplated bids for the World University Games as well. So a country that is continuing to expand its sport culture. Hungary historically a very strong power in men's water polo.
Indo.
India.
And.
And now India. And again, you see there the more business-like attire on the Indians. A whole range. I'm by no means a fashion expert. But you'll see all kinds of different uniforms that you've already noticed here tonight, from the very professional look as you see here from the Indians in terms of more business type attire, to some countries with shorts and t-shirts making their way out.
Indonesia!
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 And Indonesia makes its way out. Of course, not too far away for them to get to Gwangju from Indonesia. Now the Islamic Republic of Iran. They had a good start already in men's volleyball competition with a win yesterday. Volleyball competition has started a little bit early for the men due to scheduling challenges in terms of how the venues are being used. Of course, it's very typical for soccer or football to start before the opening ceremonies, but not as usual for volleyball to begin as early as it has.
Ireland!
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 And now Ireland. Sporting its orange, white, and green. More FISU officials there being shown.
Israel!
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 And now Israel. Notice the volunteers here in Gwangju either wearing those bright yellow jackets, or you'll see them there as well with the white hats.
Italia.
And the blue
Italy.
Sport jackets.
Italy.
And now Italy enters the Universiade Stadium. The first ever host of the Summer University Games back in 1959 in Turin. And Turin hosted the 2007 Winter University Games a year after hosting the Olympics. So it has done that rare double of hosting both Summer and Winter University Games. Italy has hosted on many occasions. Turin has hosted Summers twice, of course, as mentioned, in 1959 and then again in 1970.
Jamaica.
And then Rome hosted the Summer Games in 1975. And then on multiple occasions, as you see Jamaica make its way out, on multiple occasions they've hosted the Winter University Games. Sestriere in 1966, Livigno in 1975,
Japan.
Bologna in 1985, Tarvisio in 2003, Turin in 2007, and then Trentino in 2013, as they took those over from Maribor in Slovenia when they could no longer host. And now Japan, maybe with the brightest uniforms of the night so far, the black and fluorescent green. And Japan, another country that has hosted Summer University Games on multiple occasions. It's first back in 1967 in Tokyo. And then again in 1985 in Kobe and 1995 in Fukuoka. And then Sapporo hosted the Winter Games of 1991. Sapporo, of course, the also the host of the 1972 Winter Olympics. So again, you see that theme of countries often hosting both the Universiad and the Olympics, either in winter or summer. Tokyo hosted the 1967 Jordan. Summer Universiad, as we mentioned, and was also the 1964 host of the Summer Olympics, and will host again the Summer Olympics in the year 2020. Utilizing actually a lot of the same facilities that were present for those 1964 Olympics and 1967
Kazakhstan.
Summer Universiads. So you see that ability to create legacies and leverage facilities. Kazakhstan will host the 2017 Winter University Games, I mentioned a little while ago. They have now made their way out onto the field of play here at Universiad Stadium. And Almaty also looking to host the 2022 Kenya. Winter Olympics. And now Kenya. Another very strong
Kyrgyzstan.
Distance running power
Kyrgyzstan.
In the world.
Kyrgyzstan.
And they're followed by Kyrgyzstan. They're very distinctive hats.
Latvia.
Latvia.
Lithuania.
Now Latvia. Lebanon right in behind the Latvian team.
No one can save me now. Buried beneath the ground. Where to go? Where to
see? See Kyrus Gulp, member of the executive committee of FISU. Saw her Estonian flag in her hand.
Liberia.
Liberia.
Now Liberia.
Liechtenstein.
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 Followed up by Liechtenstein.
Lithuania.
Lithuania.
And then Lithuania.
Lithuania.
Every time Lithuania comes out, I always think back to the 1992 Summer Olympics. And their first participation post the breakup of the Soviet Union, wearing those tie-dyed uniforms.
Luxembourg.
You don't see any tie-dye here today.
Luxembourg.
On the Lithuanians. And then Luxembourg. Will make its way out.
Macedonia.
The former Yugoslav Republic of Macedonia.
And followed by the former Yugoslav Republic of Macedonia.
Madagascar.
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 No, Madagascar.
Lost in the atmosphere. Won't let go.
Malaysia.
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 Malaysia. Heads out. This is a traditional dress on some of the participants for the Malaysian team. Participation from a lot of the Asian countries with the proximity here to Guangzhou.
Mali!
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 Behind the Malaysians. Malaysia has been a strong host of the Summer University Games here over the last many years. 2001 in
Malta.
China, 2003 in
Malta.
Daegu in South Korea,
Malta.
Bangkok in 2007. Shenzhen in China, 2011. Now Guangzhou, and then in 2017,
Mauritius.
Taipei.
Mauritius.
Taiwan.
Maurice.
Mexico.
Mexico.
Mauritius
Mexico.
Followed just in behind by Mexico. City, the host of the 1979 Summer University Games. Yet another country that has hosted many different events. 1986 World Cup. The 1968 Summer Olympics. Sombreros, very visible on this Mexican team. Come in handy in a hot country like they're now here in Korea. Although again, as mentioned, the temperature today really nice, around 26 Celsius. And the forecast looking ahead over the next few days, similar in that 27 to 29 degree range.
État fédéré de Micronésie.
Now the Federated States of Micronesia. But the weather seeming to be
Moldova.
Pretty good for the
Moldova.
Athletes.
Moldova.
Not too extreme. And Moldova. Very bright. Gold, goldy orange type. Colored ties. Good aerial shot there.
Monaco.
You can see the
Monaco.
Name of the country.
Monaco.
Heads across the fans of the upper deck. And now Monaco.
Mongol.
Monaco, the
Mongolia.
Whole, the IAAF, Mongoli. The International Association of Athletic Federations. The home of track and field worldwide. And Mongolia.
Montenegro.
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 The Montenegrins making their way out. Of course, not all athletes and coaches able to participate in the opening ceremony, depending on their competition schedule. Some athletes may not arrive until later in the game. Some, if they have competition tomorrow, may choose to not march.
Morocco.
Morocco.
Maroc.
Morocco. Northern African nation.
Mozambique.
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 Left behind by Mozambique.
Namibia.
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 Nepal.
Followed by Nepal.
Nepal.
As everyone knows, the challenges that country has faced in the last many weeks following the earthquake in Nepal. Back there in late April. Nepalese flag, not the traditional rectangular shape that you see it there. The double triangles of the Nepalese flag, and now the Netherlands. Traditionally a very strong cycling and speed skating nation. Cycling not part of the program here for Guangzhou's Universiad. That's, I think, rarely a sport that is competed at Universiad.
New Zealand!
Back in 1983,
New
it
Zealand.
Was a
Nouvelle
sport.
Zealand!
And now New Zealand. New Zealand has hosted the Commonwealth Games, but never the World University Games.
Niger!
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 New Zealand was the recent host of the under 21 World Cup of Football.
Nigeria!
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 Niger followed now by Nigeria.
Bung Mariana Jedo.
Northern Mariana Islands.
Île Marianne du Nord.
Norway.
Northern Mariana Norway. Islands.
Norvège.
Just in behind them will be Norway. Another very strong winter sporting nation, dominant in speed skating. Speed skating as
Oman.
Well as cross-country skiing.
Oman!
Oman!
Now Oman. Again, very traditionally dressed here, so you get that range and contrast uniforms, dress that the countries choose
Pakistan.
To wear.
Pakistan.
Pakistan.
Palestine.
Pakistan.
Palestine.
Palestine. Palestine.
Palestine.
Panama.
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 The Panamanians.
Paraguay.
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 So the blue and red flag of Paraguay.
Peru.
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 Philippines.
Philippines.
Filipina.
They're the Philippines. There's them with the bright yellow hats on. Supporters in the crowd cheering them on as they make their way into the stadium.
Poland.
Poland.
Bologna.
Poland. Twice the host of the Winter University Games. Both times in Zakopane in 1993, then again in 2001.
Portugal!
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 Portuguese just in behind Poland. Guangzhou's Universiad will comprise of 21 sports, 13 compulsory sports, and 8 optional sports.
Qatar!
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 We'll get back to the sports in a second. There you see Qatar. Upcoming of the 2022 World Cup of Football. Of course, all kinds of controversy around that.
Romania.
Romania.
We won't dive into, but back to the sports. 21 sports, 13 compulsory, 8 optional. The compulsory sports are artistic gymnastics, athletics, basketball, diving, fencing, football, judo, rhythmic gymnastics, swimming, table tennis, tennis, volleyball, and water polo. And the 8 optional sports that were chosen by the Guangzhou Organizing
Russia.
Committee: archery,
Russian
badminton,
Federation.
Baseball,
Federation
golf,
de Russie.
Handball, rowing, shooting, and taekwondo. And now Russia. Russia, the last host of the World University Games, the summer version in 2013 in Kazan, where it was an unbelievably dominant performance by the Russians as they won well over 300 medals. Nobody anywhere close to them in Kazan. We just talked about Qatar being the host of 2022 World Cup of Football. Russia will host the 2018 World Cup. A range of cities including Kazan. Of course, Guangzhou was one of the cities that hosted the 2002 World Cup of Football when they split it between South Korea and Japan. Russia, too, one of the largest delegations at every university had winter and summer. Moscow also hosted the games back in 1973 when Russia was still part of the Soviet Union. darkness has fully set here on Universiad Stadium in Gwangju.
Rwanda.
The light that I talked about off the top will become ever present here now. We'll continue the ceremony. Rwanda right in behind the Russians.
Senegal.
There is Senegal.
Serbia.
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 Now Serbia. Another strong power in world water polo and basketball. Did a wonderful job hosting in Belgrade in 2009.
Sierra Leone.
Sierra Leone.
Sierra Leone.
That is Sierra Leone.
Singapore.
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 The city-state of Singapore.
Slovakia.
Slovakia.
Slovakia. Slovakia. Oh, the flag bearer gets a little bit of an extra boost. There's that Slovakian flag. Athletes having a great time down
Slovenia.
Here on the field.
Slovenia.
Slovenia.
Talked earlier about the fact that Slovakia is one of the two hosts of this most recent Winter University Games back in February, and there's Slovenia. Srpski Pleso and Orsli, Slovakia, was where part of the sports program took place. They've also hosted the Winter
Solomon
Games.
Jettel.
Solomon Islands.
Previously, Poprad Patry back in 1999. And again, Srpski Pleso hosted and was part of Czechoslovakia back in 1987.
Afrique du Sud.
South Africa makes its way out. See the South African flag, a stylistic way used on the front of the uniforms for the South African team. Again, I need to keep my fashion comments to a minimum, because I would never be confused as being a fashion aficionado.
Spain!
It's always España. Fun to see what the teams do wear, and there is Spain. Did a great job hosting the Winter Games in Granada. The 1999 Summer Games are hosted in Palma de Mallorca.
Sri Lanka!
Sri Lanka!
Sri Lanka!
And Yaka also hosted the Winter Games back in 1981. So Spain. Yaka, actually, I should correct myself, a two-time host back in 1981 and then 1995. There's Sri Lanka. Jog his way around the track,
Swaziland.
But he's ready to if he needs to. Now Swaziland.
스웨덴
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 스웨덴 Never hosted a summer or winter university games, despite always having a large presence.
Swiss!
Switzerland!
Stefan Berg.
Swiss!
Senior member and vice president of FISU. He's from Sweden. And there is Switzerland. Belgians came out, I talked about the fact that Belgium is one of the two host countries for FISU, as we see some nice somersaults there on the track. Not sure what kind of scores they get for those, but they look pretty impressive. So Belgium, one of the sites of FISU's headquarters, and then Lausanne in Switzerland, the other site. Many international sports federations make their home in Switzerland. A lot of those in Lausanne, but not exclusively in Lausanne.
Pema!
Chinese Taipei!
Taipei Shin!
Chinese Taipei. A strong performance today in men's volleyball where they defeated Korea 3-1. And Taiwan will host the 2017 World University Games, as you see on those banners being waved by various members of the audience here tonight. So that delegation will be very present here in Guangzhou as they gear up and get prepared to host in 2017.
Tajikistan.
Now to the stadium.
Tanzania.
United Republic of Tanzania.
République Unie de Tanzanie.
United Republic of Tanzania.
Taegu.
Thailand.
Their flag Thailand. Very well in those nice hats they're wearing. Bangkok in Thailand hosted the 2007 Summer Universiad. They are no strangers to this major event. Trinidad and Tobago. A little bit about some of the Caribbean countries that are here tonight, and there is another one.
Tunisia.
Turkey.
And now Turkey. Turkey has twice hosted the World University Games in the last 10 years. 10 years ago, the 23rd version of the Summer University Games were held in Izmir. And then in Erzurum in 2011. They hosted the Winter Games. beautiful shot there of the stadium and all the Uganda. Lights flashing all over.
Uganda.
Uganda. Universiad Stadium. And this stadium, the Universiad Stadium, will be used first here for the ceremonies, but then also for athletics. Which will come up later here in Gwangju. They get going on Wednesday, July 8th. On the schedule tomorrow, archery will get going, as will basketball.
Ukraine!
Biden will be into day two.
Ukraine!
Ukraine. Fencing will begin. Football will have its second day of competition. They didn't compete today, but did yesterday on Thursday, July 2nd. Gymnastics starts up. As does judo, swimming, tennis, and then volleyball and water polo will continue. Water polo, the only sport that will be competed on every day here at Universiad, including the 2 days prior to the opening ceremony.
Yumbo.
They will go right up
United Kingdom of Great
the final
Britain
day
and Northern
on
Ireland.
Tuesday the 14th. Why back on that 14th, the only things happening will be the closing ceremony, and then water polo. Now the United Kingdom. The UK hosted in Sheffield back in 1991. The time that they have hosted a Universiad.
Meagles!
First London
United
game.
States of America.
First ever third time host. The Summer Olympics back in 2012 when London hosted. And also hosted back in 1948 and in 1908. Now the United States. Always one of the largest delegations and always one of the athletic powers at any major event. They'll be looking in intently as the Americans get ready to take on Japan in the Women's World Cup of Football final on Sunday, July 5th. Americans knocked off the Germans for the right to take on the defending champion Japanese. See the president of the Republic of Korea. She applauds. She's been applauding a lot throughout the athlete parade. There you get a good look at the whole American delegation. Buffalo, the only city that has hosted a summer university game, that took place back in 1993. Then Lake Placid hosted the winter games back in 1972. Lake Placid, the 1932 and 1980 host of the Winter Olympics. Americans expected to be very strong again in many sports. The men's basketball team is comprised exclusively of members of the Kansas Jayhawks. University team back in the United States. Traditionally, most teams will bring athletes from various parts of their country, but in this case, Kansas University Jayhawks will be representing them in men's basketball. Beautiful shot there of the Universiad Stadium. All the lights around. This wonderful open stadium.
우루과이.
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 Never hosted a Universiade, but it's the first ever host of the World Cup of
Uzbekistan.
Football.
Uzbekistan!
Uzbekistan!
Uzbekistan.
Venezuela.
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 Venezuela. My pair is falling a little bit behind the country name bear. As you see, each team that comes out will have someone bearing the name of the country. And right in behind them will be the flag bearer. Colorful team here, Venezuelans.
Vietnam!
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 Vietnam.
Virgin Islands!
Virgin Islands!
Île Vierge!
Virgin Islands. Very colorful pattern shirts.
Zambia.
Zombie.
There is Zambia. We are closing in on the end of the athlete parade.
Zimbabwe.
Majority of spectators is
Zimbabwe.
Waiting to see. Zimbabwe now enters. We too choosing to go the sport jacket way here tonight. Start to hear that roar building up here in Universiade Stadium. And that will tell you it is the Republic of Korea.
Finally, here is your host country, Republic of Korea.
Finalement, le pays hôte, la République de Corée.
It is Korea who will, as tradition dictates, the host country, always the last one to enter the stadium. And Korea who beat out Edmonton in Canada. Taipei in Taiwan to host these 2015 Summer University Games. Guangzhou was awarded them back on May 23rd, 2009. They had unsuccessfully bid for the 2013 games that were won by Kazan, Russia. Always a thrill, of course, for the athletes from the host country to make their way out into the stadium in front of their loving supporters. There you've seen them, 143 countries strong. Just over roughly 10,000 athletes. They will compete between now and July 14th.
Universiade 대회는 총 144개국에서 13,000명이 참가한 세계 대학생들의 스포츠 축제입니다.
Gold, silver, and bronze medals up for grabs.
Is participated by 13,000 delegation members from 144 countries.
Correction, 144 countries.
여러분, 다시 한번 큰 박수 부탁드립니다.
13,000 delegate members. Now that will include athletes, coaches, officials, trainers, etc. So that's not all athletes. So the athlete number, as mentioned, roughly in around 10,000. The Korean delegation continues to make its way around the field to the seating area. Get a good look there at the layout of the stadium. Earlier we went through the visual concept behind it. The other element to this is that it is a Korean-style theater, also known as a manigori, where youth integrates and expands. The taeguk, the national symbol of Korea, forms harmony, and hundreds of lighting frames that symbolize the values and exchange of youth come together in the center of the field to express numerous words that define youth. And we've seen that over the course of the evening from some of the young citizens here of Gwangju talking about what their city means to them, and as well giving you various words and descriptions that make up what the Universiade is all about. And so they've tried to bring that as well into how this
the future lights
space
of the world
stage
have gathered
is brought
here
together. And there you
in
get a
Gwangju
good aerial view of it. That will lead us ultimately into the second cultural performance, which is entitled The History of Knowledge and Communication. Started off with Light the Birth of Youth. And momentarily we'll move into that second performance. And then you see all the brightly colored boxes that have the country names on them.
대한민국 광주로 모였습니다.
Gwangju.
이제 12일간 꿈과 열정이 이곳에서 펼쳐질 것입니다.
Now the 12-day journey begins.
A beautiful shot there of all the countries' flags projected on to that white canopy on the field level of the stadium.
Everyone, 아름다운 도전에 나선 세계 젊음에게 다시 한번 큰 박수 부탁드립니다.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome them once again with a big round of applause.
Here, one final rousing round of applause.
더 큰 함성과 박수로
all of the
부탁드립니다.
Participating
ladies
delegates
and gentlemen,
here.
Let's welcome them once again.
Of course, the focus is always on the athletes. You can't forget how important it is to have the coaches, the officials, and the trainers to make sure that these athletes can perform to their peak.
이제 젊음의 배움과 소통을 주제로 한 두 번째 문화 공연이 시작됩니다.
Next is our second cultural performance titled History of Knowledge and Communication.
words, the history of civilization. Youth learns and communicates endlessly to give light to the world with new knowledge and technologies. The youth of the world will now be connected as one to open a new door to the future. And the first chapter in this history of knowledge and communication is the beginning of learning and communication. Process of youth's effort to learn and communicate through language and letters is expressed with Hunminjeongeum, Korean character. second chapter called HAFTEM, the Academia Sports, Science, and Technology and Arts that the youth have created and were spread out, expressing the path of youth that have led the civilization of mankind. City following the opening ceremony here tonight. Third chapter, Youth of Today. You see that gigantic smartphone. You know, phones are getting pretty big, but maybe the biggest one I've ever seen. In this chapter, the youth of today are interacting with each other with their cheerful language in a world connected by internet and smart devices. The youth from all over the world wish to share their knowledge and dreams and wish to open a better future. wonderful shot there of the beautiful fireworks display. Wraps up that third chapter of youth of today. Well, the song is very good. Finale, the second cultural performance. I'm very, very good.
Please give a big round of applause to the cast members for their outstanding performance.
There you have the song, Very Good. I'm sure people are feeling very good as this 28th Universiade gets underway.
2015 광주 하계 유니버시아드 대회 조직위원회 김황식 위원장, 광주광역시장 윤장현 위원장, 국제대학 스포츠연맹 루이스칼리앙 회장이 함께 입장하고 계십니다.
김황식, the president of the 2015 Gwangju Universiade Organizing Committee, 윤장현, the mayor of Gwangju Metropolitan City, and Claude Louis Galliang, the president of the International University Sports Federation, will now deliver their addresses.
Yun Jang-hyun,
the mayor of Gwangju Metropolitan City, will deliver a welcome address.
There you see the mayor of Gwangju,
세상에 빛이 될 빛나는 청춘 여러분, 이 시간을 함께하고 있는 지구촌 가족 여러분, 빛의 도시 광주가 여러분을 뜨겁게 환영합니다. 오늘부터 12일간 이곳 광주에서 펼쳐질 유니버시아드는 스포츠대회 이상의 의미를 갖고 있습니다. 건강한 몸에 건강한 정신이 깃든다는 것은 동서고금의 진리입니다. 건강한 사람은 사회를 건강하게 하고 지구촌을 건강하게 할 수 있습니다. 유니버시아드는 건강한 대학생들이 스포츠를 통해 보다 나은 지구촌을 위해 열정과 우정을 나누는 축제의장이 될 것입니다. 이곳 광주는 빛의 도시라 불리웁니다. 빛은 어둠을 밝힙니다. 광주는 나라가 어려울 때마다 바른 길을 선도했습니다. 그 맨 앞에는 항상 여러분과 같은 대학생들이었습니다. 빛은 세상을 따뜻하게 합니다. 광주는 따뜻한 인정과 풍부한 감성을 가진 아름다운 사람들이 사는 곳입니다. 다정다감하기에 예술과 문화를 꽃피울 수 있었습니다. 세상에 빛이 될 빛나는 대학생 청춘 여러분, 광주에서 따뜻한 정을 느끼시고 다양한 문화예술을 즐기시기 바랍니다. 정성껏 준비한 잔치 마음껏 즐겨주시기 바랍니다. 그리고 이곳 광주에서 맺은 우정으로 이 세상을 더욱 밝고 따뜻하게 만들어주시기 바랍니다. 여러분 가슴 속의 불씨들을 모아 지구촌을 밝힐 횃불이 되어주시길 바랍니다. 대회 준비를 위해 모든 지원을 다해주신 존경하는 박근혜 대통령님과 클로드 루이 깔리앙 국제대학 스포츠연맹 회장님을 비롯한 피쉬 그리고 각국 대학 스포츠 관계자 여러분께 진심으로 감사드립니다. 오늘의 주인공인 144개국 선수단과 임원 여러분을 150만 광주 시민과 함께 다시 한번 열렬히 환영합니다. 고맙습니다.
윤 양희훈,
김황식 조직위원장께서 그 회사를 하시겠습니다.
Next, Kim Hwang-sik, the president of Gwangju Universiad Organizing Committee, will deliver the opening address.
Now, Kim Hwang-sik, the co-president of the organizing committee,
국제 대학 스포츠 연맹 회장님을 비롯한 내외 귀빈 여러분, 세계 각국의 선수단 및 심판진, 그리고 이곳을 축제의 열기로 가득 채워주신 관중 여러분, 진심으로 환영합니다. 드디어 세계 청년 대학생들의 열정과 도전이 넘치는 2015 광주 학예 유니버시아드가 시작되었습니다. 앞으로 12일간 전 세계 청년 대학생들은 광주와 더불어 정의와 공평을 배우고 상대에 대한 배려와 존중, 희생과 나눔의 가치를 향유하게 될 것입니다. 선수들의 땀과 노력은 값진 결실로 맺어질 것이고 경기장 안팎을 가득 메울 젊음의 열정과 끼는 세계인 모두가 함께 어우러지는 이 축제를 더욱 즐겁고 아름답게 만들 것입니다. 우리의 희망찬 미래는 이곳에서부터 시작합니다. 우리 청년 대학생들이 이번 대회를 통해 민주, 인권, 평화의 가치를 공유하고 정의와 선의가 승리하는 미래, 서로를 향해 기꺼이 박수를 보낼 아름다운 미래를 펼쳐나가게 될 것입니다. 오늘을 위해 지난 6년 동안 광주 시민들은 열과 성을 다해 이 대회를 준비했습니다. 그리고 이곳에서 여러분들이 마음껏 즐기시고 사랑과 우정을 나누시기를 바랍니다. 그리고 이곳에서 감동을 잊지 말고 전 세계 지구촌 곳곳에 전달해 주시기 바랍니다. 광주 하계 유니버시아드에서는 우리 모두가 주인공입니다. 여러분 함께 나아갑시다. 감사합니다.
이어서 클로드 루이 갈리앙 국제대학 스포츠연맹 회장께서 대회사를 하시겠습니다.
Next, Claude Louis Galliang, the president of the International University Sports Federation, will deliver the words of encouragement.
Your Excellency, President of the Republic of Korea, Madam Park Geun-hye, distinguished authorities, coaches, judges, referees, volunteers, students from Korea and from all over the world, dear friends, it is a great honor and pleasure for all the Fizu family to be here today. We feel at home in Korea, which hosted already two fantastic Universiades. We feel at home in Gwangju, the city of light, culture and education, the city whose students are both a living memory and a hope for tomorrow. The 28th Summer Universiade in Gwangju is the major international multisport event of the year 2015. But it is much more than that. It is 6 years of hard work before the event itself and a great heritage after the games are over. The legacy of this Universiade shall be dream and ambition through the dual project proposed by FISU to student athletes, champions today and tomorrow's leaders. A dream. The world of sport is currently in trouble. The whole world goes bad. During this Universiade, let us dream together, because when dreaming together, we can change the world, and this world certainly needs to be changed. Remember, not only politicians, scientists, lawyers, or businessmen can change the world, but also athletes can change the world, and students can change the world. Ambition? Dream big! There should be no limit on your ambition. During this Universiade, let us be ambitious together, because when competing together and not against the other, we can achieve true victory. The only true victory is to conquer yourself. Mes amis, je suis convaincu que tout est possible pour ceux qui rêvent, qui osent, qui travaillent ensemble et qui jamais n'abandonnent. Vous êtes de ceux-là. Avec vous et pour vous, tout est possible. On behalf of all Fizu family, I would like to say Sarang Ye Ho. Together, Manse, Manse, Manse. I now invite the President of the Republic of Korea, Her Excellency Madam Park Geun-hye, to open the games. Thank you.
Trademark rousing the crowd.
광주 하계 유니버시아드 대회 개회를 선언하시겠습니다.
빛의 도시 대한민국 광주에서 세계의 젊음이 함께하는 제28회 광주 하계 유니버시아드 대회 개회를 선언합니다.
Have it. Games of the 28th Summer Universiade are officially declared open by Park Geun-hye, President of the Republic of Korea. As you heard President Gagnon say in his remarks, this is 6 years of effort once they received the opportunity to host, and of course, much time spent as part of building up the bid for these 2015 Summer
Ladies
World
and gentlemen,
Games.
The symbol of Universiade, the FISU flag. Future sports stars of Gwangju are entering with the FISU flag.
The FISU flag will be brought in by future sports
먼저,
stars of Korea.
검도 종목의 최용찬 군.
First, 최용찬, Kendo.
이어서 복싱 종목의 홍희영 군.
홍희영, Boxing.
소프트볼 종목의 김아영 양.
김아영, softball.
사이클 종목의 황소진 양.
황소진, cycling.
하키 종목의 조현성 군.
조현성, hockey.
역도 종목의 손현호 군.
손현호, weightlifting.
태권도 종목의 김서희 양.
김서희, 태권도.
마지막으로 펜싱 종목의 김진솔 양입니다.
And 김진솔, fencing.
So young athletes, as the flag makes its way across the stage, raised alongside the flag of the Republic of Korea. The Korean military will again do the honors.
The
FISU flag will be hoisted to the FISU anthem. Please rise from your seats.
선수단 여러분들은 대회기를 바라봐 주시기 바랍니다.
Athletes, please face the FISU flag.
The FISU anthem, Guadiamas Igitur, will play as the flag is raised here at Universiade Stadium.
Somos gaudiamus igitur, juvenes tum somos, postiucum dam juventutem, post molestam senectutem, nosta bebitumus, nosta bebitumus.
앉아주시기 바랍니다.
Chorus from the Korea National University of Arts with a really beautiful rendition there of Gaudeamus Igitur.
선수 및 심판 대표의 선서가 있겠습니다.
Up next, the oaths of athletes and oaths of referees and judges.
선수 대표는 육상 종목의 김구경 선수와 유도 종목의 김성현 선수입니다.
The athlete representatives are Kim Gugyeong of athletics and Kim Sung-hyun of judo.
Sonso, 모든 참가 선수들의 이름으로 나는 모든 규정을 준수하고 도핑과 약물 투여를 하지 않으며 스포츠 맨십과 페어플레이에 진실된 정신으로 우리나라의 영광과 우리 팀의 영예와 국제대학 스포츠 운동의 업적을 위해 유니버시아드에 참여할 것을 약속합니다. 2015년 7월 3일 선수대표 김국영,
김성연.
네, 페어플레이를 약속한 선수들에게 큰 박수 부탁드립니다.
Please give a round of applause to the players who promised fair play.
이어서 심판 대표 육상 종목의 박미선 심판과 야구 종목의 김대남 심판이 선서를 하겠습니다.
Next, representatives of referees and judges, Bang Mi-sun of athletics and Kim Dae-nam of baseball will swear oaths.
선서! 모든 심판과 위원회 이름으로 나는 스포츠맨십의 진실된 정신으로 경기 규칙을 존중하며 따르며 유니버시아드 경기를 공정하게 판정할 것을 약속합니다. 2015년 7월 3일 심판대표 김대남,
박미선.
네, 다시 한번 힘찬 응원의 박수 부탁드립니다.
Please give another big round of applause.
이제 오늘의 마지막 공연이 시작되겠습니다. 미래의 빛, You Are Shining이란 주제로 꾸며진 이번 공연은 대회를 밝혀줄 성화 점화로 이어지겠습니다.
You Are Shining.
Up next is tonight's final performance. With the title, You Are Shining, the performance will be followed by the lighting of the flame.
In this performance, a single ray of light brightens the darkness of space, but when many come together, it can brighten the entire world. The light that brightens the future of mankind is ourselves. Is called Light Within Us. Youth, including youth of light, are brightly living on in a world glittered by each of their dreams. environment, war, starvation, natural disasters. Come and the youth of light, and the youth gradually lose their light. Despite all the light that is ever present. Fire add to the light in this performance. On to the third chapter. The message of life. The goddess of life approaches from the other face of this dark world to bring the youth of light to his feet again.
Oh.
from her skirt. 어둠 속 지쳐 쓰러져 희미해진 빛 작고 외로워도 꿈꾸길 포기하지 않았네 간절한 목소리 용감한 그 몸짓 세상을 밝히리 The world gather and make the pillar of light and hope tower to the sky. We'll be right back. shapes that have been a major part of his performance, now raised well above the stage. There are elements of the Hope Tower. Center of the stage. Onto the stage as well as onto the tower. This will be the final culmination of our journey tonight through the discussion and imagery of light.
Good morning. You've made it, and we've made it to 1984. You and I are here today to say hello to a notorious new year as we recover from saying goodbye to an old one.
Beautiful use of the projection mapping onto those
살이 놀까 한강술래 원료도 침월됐고 한강술래 하늘 주사가 다 넘어간다
한강술래 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 한강술래
해수나무 바뀌었구나 강술래 강강술래 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 해들아 칭칭 나네 강강술래 해들아 칭칭 나네 술래 술래 강강술래 해들아 칭칭 나네 강강술래 해들아 칭칭 나네
다음은 12일 동안 젊음의 여정을 밝혀줄 성화가 입장하겠습니다.
The torch for our 12-day journey will now enter the stadium.
스포츠를 통해 젊음을 빛내온 분들이 이제 온 세계의 젊음과 함께 성화의 길을 걷겠습니다.
Those who have brought glory to this country in the past will now lead the way to the flame.
History of knowledge and communication in the light of future. Now the ultimate light at an event of this magnitude, the Universiad flame will make its way into the stadium.
It will be lit atop the stadium throughout the remaining days of competition. 김덕현 선수는 2009 벨그라드 유니버시아드 대회에서 금메달을 수상한 바 있습니다.
Our first bearer is Kim Deok-hyun, the winner of athletics at the Guangzhou Asian Games. He also won a gold medal at the 2009 Belgrade Universiad.
As you hear, they're a gold medal winner in Belgrade in 2009, as well as at the Asian Games in 2010.
The
torch now will be relayed to our second bearer.
두 번째 주자는 2012 런던 올림픽 펜싱 단체 은메달리스트 최은숙 선수입니다.
Second bearer is Choi Eun-suk, the women's team FA silver medalist at the 2012 London Olympics.
최은숙 선수는 2014 인천 아시아 경기 대회와 2013 카잔 유니버시아드 대회에서 은메달을 수상한 바 있습니다.
She has also won silver medals at the 2014 Incheon Asian Games.
세 번째 주자는 1992년 바르셀로나 올림픽 탁구 단식 복식 종목에서 동메달을 수상한 전 대한민국 국가대표 김택수 감독입니다.
The third bearer is Kim Tae-su. The singles and doubles bronze medalist in table tennis at the 1992 Barcelona Olympics and the former coach of the national table tennis team.
1992 Summer Olympic Games in Barcelona. Just to lay it up, I mean, that opening ceremony was the first
2015 세계 태권도 선수권대회 금메달리스트인 임금별 선수입니다.
The fourth bearer is Im Geun-byeol, the winner of the 2015 World Taekwondo Championships.
Im Geun-byeol, World Taekwondo Championships winner.
The fifth contender is 2012 런던 올림픽과 2013 카잔 유니버시아드 대회 체조 종목의 금메달리스트 양학선 선수입니다.
The fifth bearer is Yang Hak-sun, the vault gold medalist at the 2013 Kazan Summer Universiad and the 2012 London Olympics.
Multiple gold medalist Yang Hak-sun. Gymnastics, both the 2012 London Summer Olympics and then at the Summer Universiade in Kazan in 2013.
이제 성화가 최종 주자에게 전달되겠습니다.
Now the torch will be relayed to our last bearer.
Quality competition here at Universiade. Good look at the cauldron.
Mazmak 선수는 세계적인 스포츠 스타 박찬호 선수입니다.
Our last bearer is Major League Baseball star Park Chan-ho.
Park Chan-ho.
1993년 버팔로 유니버시아드 대회에서 은메달을 수상하며 세계적인 야구 선수로 성장했습니다.
He won the silver medal at the 1993 Buffalo Universiade and became a global star in Major League Baseball.
이제 유니버시아드 대회를 통해 꿈을 키웠던 두 스포츠 선수가 온 세계에서 모인 젊음의 빛으로 함께 성화를 점화하겠습니다.
Now, the two final bearers will light the flame.
Both will light it.
성화, 점화!
Oh, great mystery. What is going to be the method by which the cauldron ultimately gets lit? Light up tomorrow, the theme of Gwangju Universiade leading to the lighting of the cauldron, which will stay atop the Universiade Stadium throughout the 12 days of competition here in South Korea. There is President Park Geun-ki. Applause the lighting of the cauldron.
2015 광주 하계 유니버시아드 대회의 성화가 타오르고 있습니다. 이제 젊음의 에너지와 생명력으로 빛나는
beautiful view there of that
만들 것입니다.
The fountain below it.
The flame of the 2015 Gwangju Summer Universiade is now burning with a new light for the future.
아 look at the Universiade Stadium. The games have been officially declared open. The flame is lit. And the 10,000 plus athletes from 144 countries around the world are ready to compete
2015 광주 here at the 28
Summer University Games.
Ladies and gentlemen, the flame is up.
This is 2015 광주 하계 유니버시아드 대회 개회식의 모든 순서를 마치겠습니다. 오늘부터 12일간 선수들의 열정과 도전이 이어집니다.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the opening ceremony for the 2015 Gwangju Summer Universiad.
32 creators, 681 staff members, and 2,233 participants have worked diligently over the course of much of the last year to prepare this opening ceremony. And it certainly lived up to its billing. A wonderful use of light and sound throughout. View into history and tradition of South Korea. And a great way to start this Universiad here in Gwangju. See the fireworks there atop the stadium.
It's
a perfect finale for this evening's festivities.
Thank you very much, and we'll see you at the games.
And there, another view looking at the stadium. Fireworks all around the stadium right now. And the athletes are now ready to take center stage here in Gwangju. They have marched out in front of the audience and in front of people viewing from around the world. And it is their turn to bring together all the years of preparation that they have done leading up to these moments here in South Korea. We're very much looking forward to 12 great days of competition. 21 sports will be competed here in Gwangju. And as we have talked about tonight, it is much more than just athletic competition. It is about bringing the youth of the world together every 2 years to compete, but also to celebrate the future of athletics, but also the future of this great planet. And with that note, we will sign off from the opening ceremony to the 28th Summer Universiad here in Gwangju, South Korea. We hope from wherever you've been tuning in around the world, you've enjoyed tonight's ceremony. And we hope that you'll be tuning in as well over the course of the next 12 days to watch some excellent competition with athletes brought in from 144 countries around the world. My name is Doug McLean. I appreciate you watching from wherever you've been tonight. We look forward to bringing to you the games of the 28th Universiad over the course of the next 12 days. Thank you very much, and have a great evening or rest of your day.